cyberbullying. Most people are affected by it. It leaves a mark in hearts of people who are cyberbullying. It hurts them in every way. If you think it doesn't hurt them because it's on a computer, well, that person is wrong. It hurts anyone no matter what. Don't be a cyberbully. Everyone is different in their own unique way. It leaves a mark. It hurts. People can make a difference. You be their friend if you see somebody cyberbullied or bullied. Tell them to stay strong and tell a trusted adult. Cyberbullying happens to a lot of people in the world. Take Amanda Todd for an example. She was a 7th grader who was cyberbullied until she took her life September of 2012. Many people only know about her because she posted a video of her on YouTube. Where she
Here is Mandy, an unsuspecting 13-year-old girl on her favorite website that is a chat room about horror movies. She has met a suspicious person who calls himself Dave. Mandy shouldn't be giving away all this information, but after about 15 more minutes of talking on the computer, Mandy and Dave decide to meet up at UConn.
Where is he?
Hey, you Mandy?
Yeah?
Come with me.
I think they're giving these away.
Mandy then thanks the person that helped her and goes home knowing the importance of internet safety. Never give away any information online to anyone you do not know. And don't meet up with anyone either. People aren't always who you think they are.
In a world of IME, a boy named Charles made the biggest mistake of his life. He's chatting with someone that he's never met before.
John starts off by saying
hi. What to say.
Joe says another line back to John. Joe says, "What's up? I'm Joe." John replies, "Not much." Then, John, being a friend, says that he should not share his personal information. Then Joe says, "Thanks, friend."
John and so-called Joe have become very good friends lately. They've been IMing each other constantly.
They are now best friends, and now Joe wants to meet John.
And John takes it.
At the back of Miscoe.
John is now walking to meet so-called Joe.
John has now met Joe, and now Joe is saying that he has some candy in his car, and John is falling for the trap. And a witness has been seeing it all.
There's a witness.
Staying safe. Never share any personal information. People will try to lure you to say personal things. Never meet someone you don't know. If they are mean to you or say something disturbing, tell a parent. Statistics: 71% reported receiving messages online from someone they don't know. 45% have been asked for personal information by someone they don't know. 30% have considered meeting someone that they have only talked to online. 14% have actually met a person face to face that they have only spoken to over the internet.
on the computer talking with her only friend,
who she's never met.
Beth's friend wants to meet her.
Beth agrees.
One in five U.S. teenagers who regularly log onto the internet say that they have received an unwanted sexual solicitation via the web.
Only one in three households with internet access are actively protecting their children with filtering or blocking software. 77% of online predators targets were age 14 or older. The other 22% were age 10 to 13.
75% of children are willing to share personal information online about themselves and their families in exchange for goods and services.
Only approximately 25% of children who encountered a sexual approach or solicitation told a parent or adult.
How can this be dangerous?
Welcome to Tech Class News. This week's headline, teen Megan Anderson has gone missing.
The police believe it's due to information she has given to people online.
Don't let this happen to you.
Never share information you don't want others to see.
Yeah. Hi, my name's Abby, and I think internet safety is very important. There are three different topics I'm going to be talking about today, which are usernames, chain mail, and don't give away personal information. First, let's start off with don't give away personal information. You never want to give away personal information. A stalker is going to look for any kind of personal information about you, like your address, first name, and last name, the state you live in, and your school. If anyone online makes you feel uncomfortable about something, just let tell a trusted adult or a teacher. The predator will try to make them trust you and feel comfortable talking to them, but never trust anyone online. Let's move on to chainmail. Chainmail is when you get a text from someone like, if you don't forward this to 20 people, then your family will die. Chainmail is fake. Never open chainmail and especially never send chainmail. That's why it's very important not to open chainmail. After you receive chainmail, remember to delete it. Okay, let's move on to our last topic, usernames. A username should not have any personal information like address, school, age, name, etc. Some examples of bad usernames are Miscoe School 13, 12 Maple Court, and Billy Bob 9. The reason why we need a safe username is because predators look at our usernames to see if there's any information about you. If they do find some information, they could possibly track you down. Now let's talk about some good usernames. A good username could have your pet's name, a color, a book, or maybe an actor or singer that you like. For example, some good usernames are Selena Gomez 999, Neon Pinky Zero, or Brooke Love 899. That looks like all we have for today, but just stay safe on the internet.
Thank you. still waiting, though I still have my doubts. I am damaged at best, like you've already figured out. I'm falling apart, I'm barely breathing, with a broken heart that's still beating. In the pain, there is healing in your name. I find meaning, so I'm holding on. I'm holding on. I'm holding on.
Internet predators go on chat rooms based on interest, look for child-oriented screen names, strike up a conversation, gain their trust, and build them up to become their friend.
Teens are also willing to meet with strangers. 16% of teens considered meeting someone they've only talked to online, and 8% have actually met someone they only knew online. Internet predators tend to fall between the ages of 18 and 55, although some are older or younger. Their targets tend to be between the ages of 11 and 15.
To help stop internet predators, an international children's rights group created a fake computer-generated child to catch them. Researchers used evidence including profiles on Skype and social media to identify the suspects. The name of these suspects were passed to police.
Anyone can be a bully. Cyberbullying is the use of information and communication technologies to support deliberate, repeated, and hostile behavior by an individual or group that is intended to harm others.
Cyberbullying has successfully been defined as when the internet, cell phones, or other devices used to send or post texts or images intended to hurt or embarrass a person. Other researchers use similar language to describe the phenomenon.
Kids reporting being mean to each other online beginning as young as second grade. According to research, boys initiate mean online activity earlier than girls do. However, by middle school, girls are more likely to engage in cyberbullying than boys do. Whenever the bully is male or female, their purpose is to intentionally embarrass others, harass, and 5%
of kids have been threatened online. Nearly 1 in 5 had it happen to them more than once.
21% of kids have received mean or threatening emails or other messages.
58% of kids admit someone has said mean or hurtful things to them online. More than 4 of the 10 say it happened to them more than once.
58% have not told their parents or an adult about something mean or hurtful that happened to them online.
23% of middle schoolers have been surveyed and had been bullied by an email.
35% in chat rooms.
41% by text messages on their cell phones.